Plus an extra center command up there, so I just didn't make sense.
Absolutely. Welcome to Melrose Unitarian Universalist Church and to our celebration of life for Duane Blacklock. On behalf of Duane's parents, Bob and Phyllis, who are longtime members of this congregation, I thank you all for taking the time to join us today and to remember and to celebrate Duane. I am the Reverend Dr. Suzanne Intrilligator. I am the minister of this congregation, but I must tell you that the service today was conceived almost entirely by Phyllis, who wanted to create something special for her son. Thank you, Phyllis. Today, we will hear a few readings and some eulogies from members of Duane's family. There will be music from Paul Rutz on both the organ and the piano, and there will be an opportunity for people here to come forward and share their memories of Duane as they like. After the service, you are invited to a reception at the VFW Hall on Main Street here in Melrose. The family asked me to start today's service with a poem, "The Road Not Taken" by Robert Frost. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and sorry, I could not travel both and be one traveler. Long I stood and looked down one as far as I could to where it bent in the undergrowth. Then took the other just as fair and having perhaps the better claim because it was grassy and wanted wear, though as for that passing there had worn them really about the same. And both that morning equally lay in leaves, no step had trodden black. Oh, I kept the first for another day. Yet knowing how way leads onto way, I doubted if I should ever come back. I shall be telling this with a sigh somewhere ages and ages hence. Two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference. And now we have two eulogies from the family. First, I call forward Duane's parents, Robert and Phyllis Blacklock. Phyllis actually would like to stay there. Robert will come forward and read words that Phyllis has written for today.
It's wonderful to see so many people here. Family, friends, many of Duane's friends are here, and he would really have liked to see this because this is tremendous. Thank you so much. This is a eulogy written by my wife, Phyllis Blacklock. As many of you know, Duane went through Sunday school here and youth group at the church. It was an enlightening experience for him. Phyllis and I have been active members of this church for over 40 years. The church members make up our loving community here. Duane was one of a kind. He was loved by all who knew him. He was fun to be around. Many people said he was the light of their lives. He was as funny as a stand-up comedian, but also a practical philosopher. Duane graduated from the Melrose Public Schools studying culinary arts along the way. He then went on to Essex Agricultural and Technical School for Culinary Arts, earning an associate's degree. He went on to enjoy a very successful career in culinary arts. Duane's resume was extraordinary. The obstetrician predicted at 8 months that Duane would be a big baby. And he was, at over 9 pounds. As a newborn, he started a lifelong pattern of wanting to eat voraciously. His family and many friends could attest to that. As a toddler, Duane loved puppets, and he created his own puppet shows. He would amuse himself for hours. In fact, if I or Phyllis interrupted them or Sonia, he would say, "Go away," instead of "go." He had trouble with his blends at that age. We remember he also liked to ask as a young child, "Can I have a tookie and some toke?" Couldn't say C's, he couldn't get them out. Duane had many friends, some from elementary school and some from recent connections. Some called him D or Duboy. Duane helped many people financially and with psychological support. He was always there to help people in need. Duane was a passionate sports fan. He watched games on TV. He yelled so loud that the neighbors could hear him down the street. If there was a God for Duane, it was Tom Brady. I wonder if he's here today. In recent years, Duane developed an interest in history. He loved to read and watch documentaries on television. He truly believed that Abraham Lincoln was our greatest president. When Duane visited our home on Clifton Park, we had stimulating discussions about Lincoln. We read together the Gettysburg Address, sometimes with his nephews, Evan and Ben. We as a family are deeply grief-stricken. We will miss him forever. I do have a card I want to read now. This comes from his second grade school teacher at the Roosevelt School here in Melrose. And I know many of his friends in Melrose went to Roosevelt School, and they would know this person as a teacher in second grade, Glenda Amaralt. "Dear Bob and Phyllis, as I was reading the Melrose Weekly News last evening, I noticed Duane's obituary. I said to my husband that I remembered him well. He said, "How can you remember so many different children from Maine to Winchester to two Melrose schools?" I said, "He was earnest, he was sweet, he was kind, and I found lovable as a child." Then I read the bio about him. It matched my feelings. I was deeply sorry to learn he had passed, very much so. You and Bob, however, must also, along with deep grief, be proud of his life, his passions, and his accomplishments. With much love and understanding in the loss of dear Duane, but all of you are certainly in my focus and prayers. Fondly, Glenda. Thank you very much for listening.
Thank you, Bob. I now want to call forward Duane's sister, Sonia, and her husband, Stephen. Remind everyone that all feelings are welcome here, and there are tissues in all the pews. Just pass them down.
Thank you all for coming. Duane was more than just my sibling. He was my friend. He was my confidant and my rock. We shared so many of life's special moments together growing up as children, and he was always there at the center of everything. We had a bond that only grew stronger with every passing year. He had an uncanny ability to light up every room that he stepped foot in, and he would either have you laughing or listening intently while you were engaged in an in-depth conversation. He also would have complete strangers captivated by his outgoing personality, for that's who Duane was. When we were together as a family, as adults especially, during the holidays, he was either in the kitchen or just being the D with my parents and my two sons and my husband, Stephen, and Evan and Benjamin. I will truly miss him, but he will live on in my memory and in my heart, a heart that is filled with sustaining love and joy from him.
This is titled, "He Was My Brother, Not in Law." Just bear with me. Duane and I were brothers in every sense of the word. We had an unwritten agreement. We stopped using in-laws a long time ago. We used to laugh about it, but it was the truth, and it was how we felt about each other. We enjoyed all of life's moments together. Through all of the ebbs and flows, we could chat on the phone. When we weren't together, he was a constant source of stability. He always had my back. I think he's here right now, holding me up. When I was dating Sonia, he instilled confidence in me, telling me that Sonia is crazy about you. But I think she might have disagreed at that point. He would say, "You got this." We were on a bit of a break when she was away at Quinnipiac when she went to college. But he said, "You need to pursue her." I had no idea how to pursue his sister, who I was madly in love with. "Where do you start?" He said, "Just be yourself." I thought I was doing that. I could stand here all day and speak about how much of a great guy he was. I'm sure all of you here know that. But there wouldn't be enough time. Simply put, he was a tremendous human being. I will miss him dearly, but he will live on in my memory, and with the love he has given me, that will carry me through the rest of my days.
Thank you, Sonia and Stephen. Next, we will sing a hymn, followed by some open sharing time. While you sing, you might want to consider your own memories of Duane and choose one you might like to come forward and share with all of us here from the mic. If you would, please stand and join in singing a favorite hymn, Come Sing a Song with Me. It's number 346 in your gray hymnal. 346. Now I would like to invite anyone who would like to share a memory of Duane to come forward and speak from the microphone, just so that the people in the other room can see you and anyone who's joining us here on Zoom can see with the cameras. If you want to come forward, here's the mic. We want to make sure everyone can hear us. If people are in the other room, please feel free to come through the doors in the back and perhaps make a line if there are others here in front of you. People on Zoom, if you'd like to type something into the chat box, I could read it for you.
So I can't believe any of us are here right now for this. I could stand up here and honestly talk for days, weeks, months about the memories and experiences that I had with him, but it would be similar to the last couple of weeks, which goes back and forth between sobbing and laughing hysterically. I've known Duane for such a long time, and I was really, truly blessed to get to know him through his family as well, to know that his brilliance came from his mother, his incredible heart, and sweetest soul came from his father. And I got to see Sonia so many times give that wry smile and say, "Oh, Duane," when he had done something hilarious and silly, maybe even a little inappropriate. But you couldn't help but just smile and laugh because it was awesome, and he was awesome. He brought a pure, unbounded energy and passion to everything he did in a way that you can't really describe it. And to do so is almost futile. But through that pure passion and energy that he brought, he brought pure, unbounded joy. So no matter where you were, if you were at a party, in a house, or a bar, you knew when he walked in. He brought that pure, unbounded energy into that room, and you knew when he walked in, it changed. Some might say he was a little bit loud, but that wasn't it. It was just pure energy, and no room he ever walked into was the same after he walked into it. No person he ever met was the same after it, and my life is certainly never going to be the same, but I have 70 lifetimes of memories and joys and laughs that he gave me, but I'll certainly never be the same. I didn't lose a friend, I lost a brother, and I'll never be the same, and that's it.
Wow. Duane was one of the first kids we met when we moved to Melrose. He became part of my family. He's best friends with both of my sons. We've lived through so many happy times. As Jeff said, you always knew when Duane was there, whether he was down in the basement, whether he was out in the yard. You never had to wonder whether or not Duane had showed up. He just, I know it might sound weird, but I was so proud of him. He exceeded every expectation. People knew him. People didn't really understand, I don't think, where Duane was going to be, where he was going to get to. But he was driven. I know we're all going to miss him in our own ways. I know I'm going to miss him because of a lot of reasons, but I'm going to miss him in particular because my sons are never going to get over this. We lost a son, we lost a brother. Phyllis and Bob, I'm not sure that I could say anything else. I admired your son. I admired his tenacity. I admired his desire to do the best he could for everybody, not just himself.
So as Duane's dad noted, and anyone that knew him, you know how big of a sports fan that he was. And part of being a sports fan obviously comes arguing about statistics, which, or anything, which, you know, Duane loved to do, whether you were friends with him or a stranger, you were going to hear it, especially if you got something wrong. So for accuracy's sake, meaning no disrespect to Mrs. Amaral, Duane actually had two second grade teachers at Roosevelt because he stayed back. And my first memory, it's as vivid as anything in my life, was when he was in my grade. He was supposed to graduate in 1994. He ended up graduating in 1995. But in second grade, we had Mrs. Del Greco. And I just remember Duane being wild. And there's a story that is certainly not appropriate for a house of worship, but I'll be more than happy to tell it to anyone later at the V. But I remember it as clear as day. Just know that it involved, we used to have hot dog day where you'd get hot dogs for a dollar. And it was an act that was so advanced and so Duane at such a young age that it's burned in my brain and it's one of the many great memories I have of him. And so I just felt the need to say that for accuracy's sake, because Duane, I'm sure, would be like, no, I had two second grade teachers. If you knew him, look, he wasn't a person, he was a presence. And like Jeff said, I can't even wrap my head around the fact this is real, but it is. And he'll be terribly missed. And Tom Brady meant the world to him. If something was great, he referred to it as the Tom Brady of. And you know, my wife used it in a eulogy she put on Instagram, and all I gotta say is Duane was the Tom Brady of people, and I'll miss him.
You can probably tell I'm Bob's brother. And we look a little alike, maybe even sound a little alike. This is a story about parties, and I know that everybody that knows Duane has been in some kind of party with him. Well, many years ago, we moved to a house, we got a pool in the backyard, so we were the relatives with the pool, so I guess we should throw the party. So we started a July 4th party celebration. And, you know, Duane came that year. And I honestly thought it was a one-off. This was going to be the only time we were going to throw this party. But Duane wouldn't have it. Before we all left that day, he was the one that said, we got to do this every year. And we've been doing it. Thanks. You owe me a lot for hamburgers and but it was phenomenal. And we would have some pretty wild cornhole tournaments at that party as well. And the game was new to Duane, you know. But he's very humble. If he got you as a partner, the first thing he'd do was apologize. You go, no, Duane, have fun. And then he'd throw a couple of bags, and you'd see the competitive juices start flowing. And then he wasn't, you know, we won some of the prizes some years when him on your team. So, yeah, he's a good partner. But anyway, I was trying to cover, you know, the partying part of Duane, and it was almost like, you know, he would come usually a little bit late, not real late, but fashionably late, and everybody would be out in the backyard and just kind of talking, and it was a kind of a low murmur, and then Duane would walk through, and it was almost like, you've all seen Cheers, right? When Norm would come into the bar, Norm, big Duane, you know? And so, you know, then we knew the party started. So just wanted to say I'm going to miss him terribly. Completely shocked. But, you know, we all know the soul that Duane was, and I'm sure he's doing just fine right now. So.
Is there anyone else who would like to share about Duane today? I would just like to say on behalf of our congregation, our hearts are just broken for you, Bob and Phyllis. I didn't know Duane, but I hear about what a wonderful person he was, and he was taken far too soon, and our hearts go out to you, and we want to take care of you and be with you and help you through this loss. We are so sorry. Thank you for everyone who shared. Now we're going to have a musical interlude, a time for you to reflect, sit peacefully, cherish your memories of Duane. Paul will play for us now, All You Need Is Love. Now one of Duane's closest friends, Dan, will come forward to read a short piece that Phyllis wrote for her son. If you would please, Dan, come up. Thank you. Would you mind coming all the way up here and reading from this microphone? Yeah, all the way there. Thank you.
What a tremendous bunch. Here's an email written by Duane's mom and dad to Duane on his birthday, February 28th, 2022. Happy birthday, dear Duane. A word play on the letter D. We are delighted to have you as our devoted son. Day after day, we think of you with the deepest affection. For years, you have prepared delicious and delectable food in your professional jobs in our domestic domicile. You have always contributed to the happiness of your family, friends, fellow employees on a daily basis. Your dynamic personality delivers from dusk to dawn. With our enduring love, Mom and Dad. I love you, Duane. And one last time, that's a fact.
Would you please now stand and join in the hymn, Amazing Grace? It's in your gray hymnal, number 205. Please, if you would, remain standing and join me in the spirit of prayer as we say a formal goodbye. Duane Errol Blacklock, son, brother, uncle, friend, and colleague, it is in deep sadness, but also in profound gratitude for the person that you were and the gifts that you gave, that we bid you now farewell. We return you to the earth, the air, and the sky, the elements from which you came, the elements of all life, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated. The poet Brian Patton wrote, "How long does a man live, after all? 1,000 days or only one? 1 week or a few centuries? How long does a man spend living or dying? And what do we mean when we say, gone forever?" We fret and we ask so many questions. Then when it comes to us, the answer is so simple, after all. A man lives for as long as we carry him inside us, for as long as we carry the harvest of his dreams, for as long as we ourselves live holding memories in common, a man lives. We have been celebrating today the life of Duane Blacklock, a man of kindness and good cheer, a man devoted to his family. May his memory live on in your kindness, your good cheer, your devotion to family and friends. Let us now return to our lives and our work, resolve that we who live on will use our lives more fully and to better purpose for having known Duane and for having shared in his life. Duane's family would like to thank all of you for coming today, for showing your respect and your support. They invite you again to join them after the ceremony today at a reception at the VFW Hall. We close our ceremony today with a song that pays tribute to Duane's love of sports. His parents requested it. It's "Take Me Out to the Ball Game." Sing along as you like, and thank you again for taking part.